Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can pass an array into a function using pointer. So before starting explanation, if you go to description of this video, you will find links of various playlists related to C language videos, so you can follow them as well. So now I am coming on to this topic. So first of all, I am going to declare a function. So let's say this is function declaration. So here name of function is sum. Its return type is integer, and it will be receiving an argument as input that will be an array, but that array will be received into a pointer. So that's why here I have mentioned int asterisk, right? So whenever you pass any array into a function and you want to process it with the help of pointer, so remember, always you need to declare a pointer here. Now I'm starting main function. Inside main function, I am declaring an array and initializing it with 5 values. So size of array is 5, and it is having 5 values as initial value, and one more variable, that is s, which will be storing sum. Now after this, I am just calling sum function and passing this array as an argument into it. So this statement is function declaration, and this statement is function calling, right? So here you can see I am passing an array as an argument, and the result will be stored into this s variable when this sum function will be returning the calculated value. And after this, I can write printf sum equals to %d and variable s, and then I can close the main function. So remember that in this program, I have initialized these values by myself. So if you want to read these values from user, so remove these values from here, and after this variable declaration, you can write printf scanf statements so that you can read values from user as well, right? So after this main function definition, now I am writing definition of sum function, and here I am writing this. So this array will be passed as an argument, and that will be received into this p pointer. So here you need to remember one thing. So name of array provides its base address. So whenever you have name of any array, it means you can directly access its base address. So here we are passing name of array into p pointer. So p pointer will be having base address of that array, and through that base address, if we increase that one by one, so we will access all the elements of array, those are stored inside that array. So now we are going to use that approach. So here I am going to declare 2 variables. One is I and second one is s. Now I am going to iterate a loop. So this loop will repeat 5 times because size of array is 5. If you want to repeat it n number of times, then you need to pass size of array as an argument as well, so that inside this definition you will know how many times you need to iterate the loop. Now inside this loop, I can write s equals to s plus asterisk p, and I can increase value of p, that is a pointer, and after completion of this loop, I can simply return value of s. So this way this loop is implemented, right? So now I'm going to take an example. So suppose these are 5 locations. Name of this array is A. These are indexes, and these are values which are available inside this array, and these are addresses, right? So I am taking example for 16-bit compiler. So in case of 16-bit compiler, size of int variable is always 2 bytes. So here you can see 101 and 102. Two blocks or two addresses or 2 bytes are reserved for this first block. Then 103 and 104 are reserved for this second block, and so on. So total 10 bytes are allocated here, and here we are passing base address of A, and it is received through P pointer. So if I drop P, so it will be having 101 as a value. Now here S plus asterisk P. So this asterisk means value at address. So address is 101, and the value which is available on this address is 11. So this 11 will be added into S. Then P will be incremented. So P is a pointer of integer type. So integer pointer always increases its address that is stored inside it by 2 bytes, because we are talking about 16-bit compiler. So it will move to 103 location by this P++. Then I will be incremented for second rotation. Now we need to add S plus asterisk P. So this time P is having 103 as address. So value at this address, because asterisk P is available here. So value at 103 is 12. So 12 will be added into S variable. So this way P will jump its location one by one, and through asterisk P, we can access the element which is available on a particular address. So if we talk about this function definition, so here you can see we have not used anywhere name of array. We just used addresses of the array through this pointer. So this way you can pass any 1D array into a function, and that function will receive that array into a pointer, and through that pointer you can process it. And after completion of this loop, the result of S will be returned into this S variable, and it will be displayed here. Right? So this way, I hope you understand, or you understood whatever I explained related to passing array into function with the help of pointer. So after watching this video, you have two options. You can pass this array into another array. So we can also use this notation. So this array will be passed into this array, right? But if you don't want to use any array and you want to process it with the help of pointer, so this is another notation, right? So after completion of this video, you will find a link of playlist where you can see videos related to pointers in C. So there, all pointer related videos are available, so you can watch them too. And if you want to watch all related playlist of C language, so go to description of this video and you will find links of all available playlists on my channel on this description of this video. So I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. Thank you for watching this video.